Hey folks, Mike Bazine here, and welcome to Thursday Night VH Supercars America's Week 11. We're almost done with the season. God, feels like we just started. I feel like I say that all the time, but I feel like halfway it was just... Anyway, it doesn't matter. We are in Spain at the Circuit Jerez. I'm still not sure that's how it's pronounced. But this is the third time, I think, that we've been to this track. It debuted in Season 3 of last year, and it's a ton of fun with these cars. It's a lot like... the track that we were at last week, Portimao, where it's a modern circuit, it's very smooth, it's very wide, but it's super competitive. I've had some great side-by-side battles, back-and-forth fights with guys here in just a couple of races that we've run at this place, and I'm looking forward to more. The car feels really good, and we'll see how we get it on. I think there's only like 12 people here tonight, which is kind of disappointing, but... it only takes two to put on a good show. What else we got here? Derek Lovegrove, him and I are pretty quick together. Cam is always a good fight. Rich Jameson's going to be in here. So, yeah, it should be fun. I'm looking forward to it. So, I'm going to put the thing through qualifying, and we'll see where we line up. Because I honestly have no idea where I'm going to qualify for this. We are sitting 8th right now, which is a little bit lower than I wanted to be, but not terrible. The laps could have been better. I don't know if they would have been better enough to get me a position or two, but they could have been better. So, we'll see how this goes.
You'll have to stop for more fuel before the race is over. Five cars left to grid.
Kinda wish I was on that side of the track. Kinda wish I was on the other side of the grid. First two corners at this track are extreme right-handers.
Still waiting on two cars to grid.
See if we can find
good
space.
Luck, everyone.
Yes, sir. Good luck, all. Yeah, good luck, everybody. Good luck, Bob. Hopefully my internet can hold up for this one.
Waiting on the final car to grid. Everyone's gridded. Green flag, green flag. Car right. Clear on the right. Left side, clear on the left. We'll be right back. now.
Thank you. bad luck, Mike.
You're going the wrong way. The car behind is closing on you. The gap is 2.4 seconds. Car right. Clear. On the left. Car on your left. Clear on the left. Left side. Clear. The car behind is pitting. Finish line. Now. front, he's pitting. The car behind, he's pitting. Leader's pitting now. You've got about 5 laps of fuel. Car in front is pitting. They say you cut the course. You'll have to slow down and give up the time gain. You got the black flag. You cut that corner. They're going to hold you for a while. Pit box in 10, 5, 3, 2, 1. Right here. We can repair most of the damage.
Just isn't my night, huh? Boy, they really don't like it when you clip that corner. Hold for a minute and 12. Jesus. Like my race wasn't going bad enough already. I pushed it just a little bit too hard, and it didn't even suggest that it could be saved. That was instantly headed towards the wall. They're going to release me right in the middle of traffic.
Okay, go! Right side. Clear on the right.
Thanks, Mike.
Great job. 10 to go.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
Laps to go. This is less than optimal. Five laps of fuel left. Two to go. white flag. That means one more lap to go.
Well done, Bob. Good race, boys. Yeah, cheers, Will. Jason, yeah, you boys were on it. So, yeah, it's been good fun this season. I'm not going to be about next week. I'm off for the Nürburgring for the 24-hour. But, yeah, it's been good fun racing you guys this season.
Glad to have you. Glad to have you, Bob. Have a good time at the ring. Let us know how it goes.
Yeah, cheers, Mike.
They say you cut the cord. You'll have to slow down and give up the time gain. Pit box in 10.
Good racing, boys.
5.
What happened here?
3. 2.
Oh.
And 1.
Should have smashed.
Right here.
good job.
We can repair most of the damage.
I just realized this is going to count as a DNF because the finish line is way up here. Oh well.
Hey, good race, that.
Well, yeah, good race, bud. That was a lot of fun.
Oh, that was one of those character-building races. I knew I was in trouble when Cam started pulling away from me. Because I'm like, I can race Cam. I race with Cam all the time. And as soon as I was driving like as hard as I could, and he started inching away from me, I'm like, oh, we might be fucked. And then I saw Scott coming up behind me. I wasn't as worried about Scott as I was about Derek, because Derek is pretty quick. Derek's really quick, actually. And he must have had an off night. Scott caught up to me quicker. Scott caught up to me quicker than I thought I was going to have competition. So as soon as he got real big in the mirror, I just absolutely put the hammer down and took a couple of risks that I probably shouldn't have. I got away with a few of them, but yeah, coming off of that left-hander, I just dropped the right side. I dropped the right side tires off the track. I don't think it was wheel spin. Because as soon as it touched the grass, I mean, the cart just immediately turned left. I mean, a lot of times in this situation, the car will get sideways and it'll do the wiggle, you know, where you like try to save it. No, this thing, I might as well have just taken the steering wheel off the column because it was going to the fence as soon as I touched the grass. There was nothing I could have done to prevent that from happening once it started. So, yeah, and then I got the dumbass penalty on the race was already screwed at that point, but I was at the back of the pack. I could have, you know, made up a couple of positions or seen if the attrition game paid off. It didn't. But yeah, then I go in for the pit stop and I got clipped for cutting the hairpin on the inside. Because the fear is always that you're going to slide off of that hairpin pit entrance. So you want to run it kind of tight. Well, I guess I ran it a little bit too tight and they got pissed about it. But a minute and 12. Ouch. That's just brutal. Yeah, just that kind of sums up the night. Sums up the last couple of weeks, actually. Just nothing could go my way. And dirty. I don't know. I don't know if it is going to come across in the capture just because of the quality settings and YouTube compression and stuff like that, but turn one and like the whole third sector of the track, it's like any time I went in or coming out of a corner, it was just marbles everywhere. I couldn't see the racing line. I just saw dirt all over the track. I'm like, what am I driving over? Especially in turn one, I could see a clear line through turn one, but it looked like it was about this wide. And yeah, the whole third sector of the track, it's like I'm coming off of corners and I'm like, I'm driving through garbage. What am I covering my tires with right now? What's going to happen at the next corner? Yeah, I don't know. What was the deal? Where was... Practice has moderate usage, and then it carried over from there, and we only had like 12 cars here tonight. So I don't know how or why the track was so dirty. At least it looked crazy dirty. Like I said, I don't know how that, if that's going to come across in the capture, because you're talking little speckles on the track surface. Maybe you guys will see it in turn one. I don't know how well the final, that one big last loop, where basically any time that we were driving into the sun in the back half of the lap, that whole section, it's like I knew where I expected myself to run. I don't know if other people weren't running those lines. But yeah, it's like every time I looked at the track, it's like, God, I'm racing on dirt out here, which I can do. It's just I wasn't prepared for. That's in a couple of weeks you start dirt racing. So yeah, man, I don't know. Just a tough night. We survived. Two laps down, dead last, but we did survive. We brought the car home, so oh well. You have nights like that. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Take it easy. Have a good one. See you later.